Hi friends, and welcome back to another video. Today in this video we are going to look at array manipulation. Also we are going to look at some of the cool built-in functions in NumPy. So our first function is reshape. With the help of reshape function we can modify the array into another shape with the same amount of elements. And the syntax of it is numpy.reshape, and it takes three parameters. They are the array name, the shape we want to change it, and the order. There's a condition while we use the function reshape. The size of the array you want to reshape must be the same as the original. Now let's dive into an example. So first let's create an array np.arrange 10, and now I want to convert this array a to 5, 2. So for that I would use np.reshape and the array name a, the shape that is 5, 2, and the order by default is C. When I run it, I get the same elements in a form of a 2D array, which is 5, 2. Now let's look at our parameter order np.reshape a, and the shape 5, 2. And let's say the order is equals to F. And here you can notice a difference. When the order is C, that is the default order, the way our elements are arranged are in a row wise manner, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Whereas when the order is changed to F, the way our elements are arranged is in a column wise manner, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now let's try to create another array np.reshape a, 5, 3, and now when I run it, here is an error. We cannot reshape the array size of 10 to shape 5, 3. Here is why. Because our array A had only 10 elements. But when we try to convert to the array of size 5, 3, it takes 15 elements to fill in the array, which is not possible with 10 elements. And so we have got up with an error. Now let's look at our second function, that is resize. With the help of our function resize, we can change the size of our array. Now let's take the same array A, in which I am going to change the size of our array A to another. So let me take another variable B and np.resize, and in which I will pass the array name, that is A, and I want to change its size to, let's say, 3. And when I run it, I will get the array size of B to 3. And you can also see that the way it filled the elements. So when I ask the size to be 3, it filled up only with the first three elements. What if the size exceeds the normal value? Let's try that. Then we take C equals np.resize and A, let's say I want to take 5, 3, which makes an array of 15 elements. So when I run it, It starts filling out the values from 0 to 9, which sums up to be 10 elements, and the remaining 5 elements are filled up from the start. So it again starts from 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. When I take for 5 comma 4 and it sums to be 20 elements, and it fills in the value from starting from 0 to 9 as the first 10 elements, and another, and it repeats it again and completes it till 0 to 9. And our function resize works this way. Now let's look at another function, that is flatten. With the help of this function, we can get the copy of the array in one dimension. So let's see the syntax of it. And its syntax is, it takes the array name, and in the flatten function it takes only a single parameter, that is order, which is either C or F. Now let's take an example. So let's take our array C and let's try to flatten it. C dot flatten, and by default the order is C, and here we got our 1D array. Actually our array C is a 2D array, and now we flattened or we compressed it to a single one dimensional array. Now let's try to use the order F, C dot flatten, and here order equals F, and here we can see the difference. When the order is C, we get the elements in a row wise manner. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Whereas when the order is changed to F, it works in this way: 0, 4, 8, 2, 6, and 1, 5, 9, 3, 7, and goes on in a column wise manner. Now let's look at our another function, transpose. With the help of transpose function, we can change the order of our numpy array. The syntax of transpose is numpy dot transpose, and it takes two parameters. The first one is array name, and the second parameter is access. So our access parameter will come handy when we use it for three dimensional arrays. Transpose do not have any effect on our 1D array. So let me show you an example. NP dot transpose our array A. When I run it, we get the same. There is no change at all. Now let's try the same for a two dimensional array. So NP dot transpose, let's pass in our array C. When we run it, we got an array of size which is 4 comma 5. But before, our array C was in the shape which is 5 comma 4. Now let's try the transpose function for a 3D array. Let's say D equals NP dot random dot rand int. If you haven't watched the other video on random module, do check it out. Let's pass in the values, the 1 to 100, and let's say I want the shape to be 2, 3 and 4. Now let's print D, and here I got it. Now let's use the transpose function on a 3D array, that is D. NP dot transpose, in which I pass the array D, and when I run it, I got a 3D array. Here you can notice this. Now the shape of our array has been changed to 4, 3 and 2, which is just the reverse of this. At the beginning, our shape, the shape of our array was 2, 3 and 4, and now it has been changed to 4, 3 and 2. And let's also check it whether it is 4, 3 and 2 or not. Let's store it in a variable e, and e dot shape gives the shape which is 4, 3 and 2. Now let's use our second parameter, that is axis, which will be very very useful when it comes to a 3D array. When we don't use our axis parameter, we get our transposed array shape to be 4, 3 and 2, which is just reverse of it. Now let's say I want an array whose shape should be 4, 2 and 3. And how do I do that with the help of transpose function? And here is where our axis parameters comes to play. So let's try out it. F equals np dot transpose and d comma. Here we have to pass in the values. And to pass the values here, we need to understand how it works. Now let's take this 2, 3, 4 as a, let's imagine it as a tuple. And for indexing, we give 2 as 0, 3 as 1 and 4 as 2. Now, we want our array shape to be 4, 2 and 3. So, for that, I will pass in the values 4, that is 2, and 2, that is 0, and 3, that is 1. Now, when we check in for the shape, we will get an array of shape 4, 2 and 3.